Hello and welcome to another video for our December 6th, 7th, and 8th Premier Firearms Auction. My name is Danielle Hollenbeck and I work with our social media marketing team here at Rock Island Auction Company. And while I was looking through the offerings that we have coming up in December, I found one gun that really caught my eye. Now, as you know, we offer so many historic and well-provenance guns at REAC, and most of them belong to historic men. Well, this one actually belonged to a very important woman, none other than Carrie Adell Strahorn, Queen of the Pioneers. Now, if you've never heard of Carrie Adell Strahorn, you are not the only person. She's not the most famous of all the pioneers to develop the West, but her and her husband were very influential. She was actually born right in Illinois to a family of a surgeon and a very educated mother, and she preferred to go by her middle name, Adell. So throughout her whole life, that is what people called her. She had two siblings who were also daughters. They were girls, and they all went to get publicly educated their entire childhood, which was not exactly something that women had the opportunity to do. She actually went to college in Ann Arbor at the University of Michigan and studied music as soon as she could. And that was not exactly something normal for women in the 1870s. They didn't have those opportunities. When she did study music, she got to travel out east. She also went to Europe, and that kind of caught the traveling bug for her. She knew when she was young that she really didn't want to be a pioneer. She saw that her parents had traveled and had to go to Illinois from, you know, smaller towns that they had lived in, and she didn't really like that. She wrote in her book, which actually is all about her journeys out west, that when she was young, she told her mom, "I will never be a pioneer." Well, that all changed after she graduated and she met Robert Strahorn. He was a journalist, and a gritty one at that. He covered wars from the Civil War to the Sioux War. He was all over the place. So when she met him, she fell in love right away. These two were smitten with each other. And her friends told her that it'd be a calamity if she married him. But she did it anyway. In 1877, they wed, and immediately after, he got offered a job with the Union Pacific Railroad. And with this position, they would have to travel the frontier along the tracks that were going up for the Union Pacific Railroad. And he would have to write these travel guides. The purpose of these guides were to get people to move to these territories where they could make their fortune. Now, the one stipulation Robert and Adell had if he was going to take this position is she had to travel along with him. During this time, do you think people exactly would have wanted a woman in these rough terrains? Not exactly, but with a lot of persuasion and the fact that they could not lose Robert, the Union Pacific Railroad said, "It's okay, we'll let her go." So as her husband was writing these guidebooks, she was writing her own journal. This journal would later become her book that was published in 1911 called 15,000 Miles by Stage. And in this journal, she wrote about all her crazy adventures that she had traveling through Wyoming territories, the Dakotas, and going to Idaho, establishing all of these Western states that we know today. And there are a lot of insane ones. My favorite, though, happened in the 1880s, and it was when they went to tour Yellowstone National Park. When they had went there, it had just had a very light snow. All these Union Pacific Railroad workers were going to tour the park, and Adell was there with them. Well, the superintendent of Yellowstone told her that she was not allowed to travel because the snow had created dangerous conditions. But the bullheaded Adell said, "No, I'm going with my husband. I'm going to go on this ride." And they really couldn't stop her. What could they say? They'd have to hold everyone back. So she went along and she became the first woman to get to tour Yellowstone. I mean, that's pretty darn cool. She wrote all about it in her novel. If you've never read this novel, it is quite the experience. It's something that you really get a taste for what pioneer life is like, especially as a woman. As time went on in the late 1880s, Robert started working for the Idaho Oregon Land Improvement Company. And in this position, he basically would oversee all these new mining towns that were coming up all over the West. And of course, Adell traveled with him. During this time, they also invested in their own properties and they started creating all these industrial buildings and homes that they rented out to people. So this is where things got a little muddy. She would have to travel on her own because they had all these towns that they were overseeing and Robert couldn't do it alone. So as she was traveling on her own, Robert got to thinking, well, you know what? I think maybe she needs to protect herself. Maybe she needs something for protection. So that brings me to this gun right here. As you can see, there is an inscription on this gun, and it is specific to Carrie Adell Strahorn. And it is from, of course, her husband, R.E.S., which is Robert Edmund Strahorn. And it was given as a Christmas gift. Many women at this time would not have thought that a gun was a great Christmas gift, but you know what? I bet Carrie was pretty happy about it, because you think about it, when you're out on the road, you gotta hunt, you gotta protect yourself. This was actually used. This is a Colt Lightning baby carbine. And if you've seen a baby carbine, you probably know that it is usually in a smaller caliber than 32. It's usually in a 22 shorter long rimfire. This was a specially made deluxe Colt Baby Lightning carbine, actually chambered in 32 Colt Lightning magazine rifle, or CLMR. And basically, Colt did this because they didn't want to have to use a normal Winchester chambering for their rifles, because they're competition. You don't want to be giving that money to competition. So they did their own. And because this was a little bit higher caliber, that made it a little bit more of a gun that you could use for hunting. Because a lot of times these baby carbines, they'd be used for boardwalk games, you know, like shooting cans and things like that, or for smaller hunting game. But if you're out and you gotta make a meal, you're gonna want something with a little bit more power. So besides the rarity and who owned this gun, there's also a lot of deluxe features. We already talked about the 32 caliber, but look at this beautiful checkering on the wood, the nice finish on the barrel. The trigger has this beautiful niter blue, and my favorite feature, of course, is always case hardening, and there is a lot of beautiful case hardening right here on the hammer. It really doesn't get nicer than that after 130 years. This is a gun that was kept in very, very great shape. Well, there you have it. Another great selection from our December 6th, 7th, and 8th Premier Firearm Auction. If you have not yet subscribed to our YouTube channel, please press that button down below. Also, follow us on Instagram, follow us on Twitter, and like us on Facebook. We've got a lot of updates coming for this auction, and we don't want you to miss out on anything. We hope you find something in our catalog.